with Neuromyelitis Optica, and now you don't even know where to look. Yeah, that happened to me. I was diagnosed when I was 27 years old, and I had no clue where to look. I Googled, I YouTube, and everything was saying I was gonna end up in a wheelchair and blind. But I'm here to tell you that that's not true. As long as you put your mind to it, trust me, you'll be good. Now, this is not everybody's case, as well as we know that not all lesions are the same, so your symptoms will all not be the same. But I'm here to tell you my story, and hopefully this can help you out. Now, I'm not a medical professional at all. I did not graduate college for any medical reasons or any medical titles. But I am the patient experiencing everything. I will be posting content that is related to autoimmune diseases, not just NMO, and just things about my personal life that maybe can help you, tips and tricks. So what is neuromyelitis optica? Neuromyelitis optica is a central nervous system disorder that primarily affects the eye nerve, which is also the optic nerve, or the spinal cord. No one really knows why it happens or how to cure it. So my name is Adele, like I've said, and I was diagnosed with neuromyelitis optica at the age of 27. Although I was diagnosed at 27, I was having symptoms way before that, but I just wasn't associating it with it because I had no clue what NMO was. Who the heck does? I mean, I had no clue what NMO was. My symptoms started, I want to say around 2013, when I couldn't walk in heels. I was that girl that went to the supermarket in heels. I went to the bodega in heels. I went to wherever in heels. I was that girl. I had to look fabulous, you know, I was young, or I'm still young, right? And I noticed that I couldn't walk in heels. I was clumsy, I was falling a lot. One of the main things that popped out to me, my bladder was just not holding anymore urine. I was having a really tough time, and I was associating different symptoms with different things that had happened to me. I had my first child at 22 years old, and I was being told that because I had first child naturally, you know, my bladder issues could have came from the natural birth that I had done or had given to my son. So everybody kept saying, you know, you should go to a urologist, you should get the operation, lift your bladder up, like, you know, it's that easy, right? But when I did go to a urologist, for example, nothing was wrong with me. They said my bladder looks fine. It was nothing falling out of place. Everything was fine. And somehow, in some way, I just kept peeing myself all the time. Like, the urgency was crazy. Another thing with the bladder is that I was having a lot of UTIs, not knowing why. Like, and I know how to clean myself down there. So why do I have UTIs reoccurring for no reason? Some people were just saying you might just be prone to UTI. That's just what your body just is going through. Another symptom I was having a lot of knee pain on my right leg, a lot of knee pain. And when I was younger, in my teenage year, you know, I used to dance ballet. So I was associating, oh my God, all those years of dancing are coming back to me, and it's coming back on my knee. But no, it was never nothing like that. I went to an ortho, and the ortho basically said everything was fine. I don't have anything, but I'm like, I'm still having pain. What are we gonna do? So he ended up injecting steroids into my knee, which did help ease the pain, but it didn't help the problem of me still, my knee giving out or being clumsy or just not sustaining the fact that I couldn't even walk in heels. Another symptom I was having was a start of migraines. I've never in my life had migraines, and all of a sudden I was getting these really bad migraines and eyeball pain. It was like excruciating eyeball pain. Like, I couldn't even look either side because it would hurt so bad if I even looked this way or that way. It was really bad. But I just thought, hey, maybe it's from reading books or, you know, studying. I had a very successful job at this time in my life. I had to drive and commute into the city about an hour and a half, depending on traffic and how heavy it was. I also started noticing driving, I had a lot of fatigue. I would literally be falling asleep as I'm driving. Scary, I know, very scary. I remember I had a work event, which at this point, it was like my last straw with all these symptoms. I basically was the coordinator of this event, and I had to order all the foods, make sure that, you know, hotel reservations were done. I had to make sure everybody was in their place. I was basically running around everywhere. I remember as I'm running around everywhere, dragging my leg, because at this point I'm dragging my right leg, which had the knee pain, which I had the steroid shot on my knee. And I'm almost peeing myself everywhere I'm going. I literally, at one point, just stopped. I sat on a couch and just busted into tears. I did not understand what was going on with me. I did not understand why it was going on. At this point, I thought I was going crazy. So I called my PCP once again. I let her know, listen, something's wrong with me and I don't know what it is. I can't fulfill my job. I can't do this. I can't run around. I have very important people here in my job that I need to, you know, have been taken care of because we need to look good. And she said, don't worry, I'm gonna send you to a specialist. Okay, whatever. Send me to whoever the heck you need to send me to because I need to get fixed. This is like crazy. This is insane at this point. She sends me to a specialist. I didn't ask where, I didn't ask who. I just said, give me the time, give me the date, and give me the location, and I will be there. The day of the appointment comes. The first thing, I walk into the office and I see big sign that says neurologist. In my mind, neurologist, psychiatrist, all that stuff, since I'm not really in those departments, I'm pretty much healthy before any of this, I'm thinking, oh, she thinks I'm crazy. See, I never forgot this. I called my PCP in the neurologist's office and literally was screaming at the secretary. The secretary ended up getting the PCP on the phone. I'm like, you think I'm crazy? You think I'm making this up? I'm not making this up. What's wrong with you? Thank God my PCP loves me. So she's like, just give it a try, honey. We've tried everything. You're already there. The appointment's already made. Just give it a try. I'm like, fine. I'm gonna give it a try. But I mean, I don't think this has anything to do with my bladder or, you know, the fact that I'm not walking correctly right now or that I'm dragging my foot. I go see the neurologist. I tell the neurologist, you know, I'm having a lot of dragging of my foot. I'm clumsy. I'm kind of falling all the time. I feel like I'm off balance. My bladder, I keep peeing myself. I just told him everything that I was feeling and that I was going through at this point because my desperation at that time was just to find an answer. So he makes me do like these roll on the hands, the nose to the finger to the thumb. He gets me up and walk. A whole bunch of stuff just to see how I was walking. I was like, fine, whatever. And I remember at the end of the appointment, he was just like, I think I know what's wrong with you, but we have to do an MRI. I'm like, an MRI? From what I heard, that's like basically a casket that you go into. Anyways, I do the MRI. First time doing an MRI, by the way, like that was scary. I actually get a blindfold for the MRI. I didn't get no medication or anything at this time because I was like, I just want to get this done. I just want to know what's wrong with it and I don't really care. Like, let's just get it done. I did the MRI and about a week passes by and I don't hear anything. So when you don't hear anything, you just assume that everything is good, right? Yeah, right. I remember it was a Thursday and I was coming home from work. Hello? Hi, this is Dr. So-and-so. Do you have a minute to talk? At this point, my heart drops because like at 7:30 at night, you're getting a phone call from the neurologist you just seen the week before. Yeah, that was crazy. So do you have a minute to talk, he says. And I was like, yeah, I have time. I'm trying to figure out what I have, what's going on. After reviewing your MRIs carefully and with the symptoms that you've been telling me and I've seen, I've come to the conclusion that you have neuromyelitis optica. Meantime though, we have to treat you as soon as possible with some steroids and some medication called rituximab. What? The point is, I didn't believe him. I was like, yeah, whatever, nobody has this, I'm not blind, I'm not going in a wheelchair, like that's just not my case. Then I go and basically I talk to my PCP about it and I told her I don't really feel like this is my diagnosis because I feel totally fine, I'm not going blind, and leg problem, but it's not like that big of an issue. So then I go get another opinion at a different hospital. And they basically said, yes, you have neuromyelitis optica with a little bit, we can kind of say, of TM, transverse myelitis. How did this happen? Was like my question. How did I, the girl who was buying her first home, finishing college, just had her two kids, living this dream, and now I have an autoimmune disease out of nowhere? I really was a patient who Googled everything a lot of the times, but this time I didn't feel like Googling anything because not only did I have one doctor, but two doctors say that I have lesions on my thoracic part of the spine, basically saying that I'm going to have it for the rest of my life. I did not want to know what Google had to say about me for the rest of my life. So I kind of just didn't look up anything. And I didn't have the time to. I had so much going on. Ronnie, which you guys will see later on, started looking up information for me. And he was like, yeah, you need to read into this. It's pretty serious. Finally, I kind of had time to sit down and read, but my symptoms were still going on. I was still having the urgency of the bladder, like, you know, the peeing situation. I was dragging my foot. At this point, I literally had a funeral for my heels. Gave them away to my friend. Well, I ended up getting more steroids and more steroids and more steroids. And lo and behold, I gained over 40 pounds. I also started rituximab, which was gonna be every 6 months. That's basically what I've done. But for the last year, I've kind of taken the steroids away myself, suggested to my neuro. So I ended up staying with the first neurologist who diagnosed me and that medical team. But I ended up staying with the medical team, but I ended up switching to a feminine neurologist because this was affecting my intimate life as well. And I did not feel like talking about this to a man. It was pretty interesting. I mean, that was just a little fast forward of what happened to me. I can tell you in details. If you want to comment below and you want more details, let me know. I can definitely make another video in more details. Now today, I'm currently walking with a cane. I currently have the bladder situation under control, which I will talk about in another video. I can tell you that I'm fabulously living my life and accepting everything around me because there's nothing else I can do but just to be fabulously living with Neuromyelitis Optica. And follow me on Facebook, Fabnmo. Follow me on Instagram, Fab_NMO. And follow my journey. I know this is hard for anybody who's going through it, who has a family member going through it, or just an autoimmune disease period. It's all really hard because you can't see it, but we can definitely feel it. So thanks guys for watching.